We first met at Tin Roof 2 in Franklin, Tennessee, 3 weeks after I moved to Nashville.
So how I met Lacey was actually sitting right here. Me and a group of friends were here for a birthday party. And we came in after work to have like a drink or two.
And in between his table and my table, there's this like hook game.
I don't really know what the name of the game is, but the whole concept is a ring where you swing it and it lands and you put a ring on it.
As the drinks got stronger, or, you know, as they started kicking in more, I started like kind of harassing like Tim and his friends.
So she was basically sitting right exactly where you are right now, and I was taking this and swinging it, kind of like trying to hit you.
Somehow, you know, for me harassing him, we ended up hanging out all night. And then he actually asked for my phone number.
And I forgot to save it to my phone. Luckily, one of my good friends at work also got her phone number, and I asked him for it the next day because there was just something that I felt inside of me that I needed to contact her again, and I needed to see her again, and he gave it to me, and I messaged her,
and then a few days later we went out hiking. It was just the two of us, and then I realized like he is really such like a caring person. Just like he has such like a deep heart, you know? And that's like, by far, that is my favorite thing about him.
Me and Lacey, we probably knew each other, gosh, what was it, for probably about 2 months before we started to, I guess, date.
Oh my God.
Wait, why are you
only... Hair.
But, you know, there's just something about when you see the person that you want to spend the rest of your life with, that there's just something that clicks.
Okay, so he started this new thing that I think is so funny. Every time he farts, he calls it a power boost.
That's a good one. This is her. You know, this is the girl that you've been waiting for your whole life.
But I'm not marrying anything like who I thought I was going to marry. When I was little, you know, I thought I was going to grow up and marry like some blonde hair, blue-eyed man. And that's not Tim. But he definitely has the characteristics that I was looking for as I got older, you know? Someone that is a Christian and has a large faith and a big heart and someone that is caring and family-based. So, is he the man I thought I was going to marry when I was 12? No. Is he the man that I want to marry now? Absolutely.
What is this? Where am I supposed to sit?
So basically a year ago today is the first time I met his family, and it was actually really kind of funny because we rented out a clubhouse, and Tim and I like brought up like a bunch of food and stuff, and he was like, I have to take a shower, and so he basically left me here to basically let his family in that I'd never met before.
Oh, the family, they're great. They're awesome. They're funny. They're smart. And they're just good people.
Thanksgiving time is when my parents, you know, met him and my family met him. And pretty much from that moment, it's been, okay, so when are you guys getting married? When are you guys having kids?
How many kids do I want? I would say that I would like to have probably 2.
If I had my choice, I would want 3.
I have a thing about odd numbers. I don't want an odd number of kids. So to me, it's either 2 or 4.
Would want twin boys first, 2 years later I would want a girl so that the twin boys could beat up her boyfriends and I don't have to.
What is one thing that he doesn't know about me? So that means if Tim doesn't know, probably nobody in this room knows. Yikes.
One thing that she doesn't know about is...
What is one thing that Tim does not know about me?
Like how good of a singer that I actually am. I mean, she knows that my dad, you know, can sing and kind of did it very well.
This is hard.
I've been called the songbird of my generation. Kind of like a mix between Fergie and Jesus. I really enjoy singing.
I really don't know. Pits.
So, we don't have any pets at the moment.
That's actually a lie.
Well,
we don't have any at our apartment. I have two cats that are staying with my parents because Tim won't let them in the apartment.
One weighs half as much as I do.
This is true. He's a really fat cat.
Very fat.
But he does like really love to be outdoors though, and we don't even have like a patio or anything at our apartment, so that's partially why he's staying there.
Rob, yeah, it was very nerve-wracking. I didn't anticipate actually being that nervous because I'm usually not a nervous guy. But in the morning, I cooked them breakfast because they had stayed over because we were going to go into the air show and a Cars and Coffee, like an auto show. And I just randomly felt like having a beer at breakfast.
And he opens a beer at 7:30 in the morning.
And it threw Lacey off. She was like, "What are you doing?
You never do this. I have literally never seen you open a beer at 7:30 in the morning, ever." And I'm like panicking because I'm like, oh my gosh, he's going to ask my dad if he can marry me today. My dad's going to think he's an alcoholic because he's drinking beer with breakfast, you know, like.
I didn't have an answer, probably because I was nervous, to tell you the truth.
I told my mom that morning, I said, "Hey, Tim's going to ask dad today. Like, let's kind of, you know, give him some space." And she was like, "Okay." So her and I just kind of did our own thing. And Tim just followed my dad around all day.
It's following him around like a puppy, like the whole day, trying to, I couldn't figure out how to fit it in. And it just made me more nervous and more nervous and more nervous. And finally, when we got to the air show, Lacey had walked off to be with her mom. And I was like, you know what, it's now or never. It's now or never. Like, Tim, you got to do it. This is your one opportunity. Just go ahead and do it. Just get it out. And he was very chill. He was like, "All right, I know. Yep, you have my blessing." And then from there on out, the rest of that day was like a weight just lifted off the shoulder, and it was just, it actually started getting a lot more fun at that point. So yeah.
The night of the proposal, Tim told me that we were gonna go to Tin Roof 2, which is the first place that we met at. And he had talked to the manager and saved like the area that we first met. So when he proposed, I was in the same chair that we met at. I don't know why. He was playing this like hook game, and that's how we met. He was throwing the ring on the hook. And then, you know, at that point, he made it on the little hook, the ring, and he, you know, was like, "Hey, I have a confession." And I was like, "What?"
Lacey Marie Phillips. You.
But it was really funny, though. He said all these, like, really sweet things that I...
What would you
I know that he said, you know, like, he loved me and I was his best friend and he can't imagine his life without me. And, like, I know he said all those things. I remember them. But the one thing that I remember the most is that he got nervous and asked me to be his husband before he asked me to be his wife. So, like, you know, I, of course, like, laughed and was like, no, I won't be your husband. And then he's like, oh, will you be my wife? Will you marry me?
It was very nerve-wracking.
Aww.
Actually, I think I asked her to be my husband? We already have it pretty much planned. I mean, the caterer, the DJ, you know, the photographer, the awesome videographer.
So with the invitations, that was a whole hot mess. I was like being so proactive and I was like, hey, we have a venue and we have a date and blah, blah, blah. Let me go and get these invitations. And so I did. And apparently when you leave envelopes in a hot car in the summer, the envelopes stick together. So
sealed shut,
sealed
straight
shut.
Up sealed shut,
sealed shut. Like there was no there was no turning back.
There was no, like, we even had to put them in the freezer.
Spice and honey spice. Whenever I was a kid, I mean, I always, you know, was an outgoing, you know, outside, outdoorsy kid. You know, always playing in the street, and getting into trouble. You know, just being a normal kid.
I see a little silhouette of a man.
Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the fandango?
Thunderbolts and lightning, very, very frightening me.
And I just, I figured out, you know, I guess later on in life that that the woman that I was going to marry loves the outdoors. So I was like, you know, I mean, that's got to be a sign.
Thank you.
How do I know that Lacey is the one? How do I not know that Lacey is the one? She loves kids. I love kids. Everything about her, she makes me a better man. She believes in me. She pushes me. And I just can't picture life without her now.
And I love you, I love you, I love you like never before.